Hello guys, Matt here, and welcome back to this brand new episode of my Top 6 Fragrances. Now, officially on the 20th of March, it became springtime here in the UK, so stay tuned, and I hope you enjoy my Top 6 Fragrances of the Springtime of 2017. Hey guys, Matt here, and welcome to my Fragrance Ups. Hey guys, Matt here, and welcome to this brand new episode of my Top 6 Fragrances. Today, I have decided to come outside in this quite chilly weather, if I'm honest with you, but it actually feels like spring today, so I thought I would do my Top 6 Fragrances of the Spring of this year in 2017. Now, right here, I have 6 fragrances here with me, which I will personally be wearing this spring. A lot of the fragrances here that I did actually wear last year, well, there's only like 2, but yeah, I hope you enjoy this list, guys. Let's get started, shall we? Now, the first fragrance that I'm going to be wearing this spring is this fragrance right here. Now, this is a scent that can be worn in the summer also. I would say it's more headed towards spring though, because it is more of a floral fragrance than it is aquatic. And this fragrance is, well, a lot of people don't like it, but I happen to think this is an amazing fragrance. And I hope you guys agree. This fragrance is Chrome by Laurice Azzaro. Now, this fragrance came out in 1996, and this is a very nice, fresh, floral aquatic scent. It actually reminds me of CK1 by Calvin Klein. It has a kind of clean linen, fresh cotton sort of smell. However, this one is definitely more aquatic. But I would say that this one was definitely more filled on the florals. It has a lot of lavender in there. It's also got a little bit of freesia. So this is a very nice fresh scent. It actually reminds me of, I don't know why, but it reminds me of France. It reminds me of Paris, like walking down a coastal town, maybe in France, maybe Nice or something. That's the sort of vibe that I get with wearing this fragrance. It's definitely a beautiful scent. A lot of people aren't really liking it. I think it's the fact that it is a bit generic, if I'm honest with you. But it's definitely not a bad scent, and it definitely deserves a bit more praise than it does actually get. So that is my number 6, and it's Chrome by Laurice Azzaro. Coming in at number 5, guys, we're gonna go to the house of Alfred Dunhill, to another fragrance that actually came out in 1996 along with Chrome. And this one to me is Springtime in a Bottle. I absolutely worship this fragrance. Again, not a lot of people are talking about this fragrance, and I think it's due to the fact that it's actually quite hard to find in some countries. However, I was able to find this for quite a good price. I only paid like £15 for this fragrance. And online and other countries, a lot of people have been saying that it's been going for higher prices. And this fragrance is a very unpopular scent from the House of Dunhill, and it is D. I think some of you might have been expecting something like Icon. Don't get me wrong, Icon is an amazing fragrance, but I love the classic Dunhill fragrances, like Dunhill for Men and this one. To me, these fragrances are just faultless. And this one is definitely an exceptional fragrance for the spring. Like I said before, Springtime in a Bottle, it to me just invokes fields. It reminds me of fields filled with flowers, the sun is shining, beautiful sky filled with white fluffy clouds. That is the sort of vibe that I get with this fragrance. Oh, it is just absolutely gorgeous. Oh, it's so refreshing. It has a kind of a citrus in the opening, but underneath that we do get a lot of like florals. We do get a lot of bright floral smells. It actually has a little bit of a similar vibe to Chrome by Azzaro, but this one is totally different still. Same category I would put it in to Chrome though. It's a floral aquatic with some nice woody elements in there. It's got a lot of sandalwood, a lot of cedar also. But it's just, you know what, absolutely gorgeous, guys. If you're looking for a really inexpensive springtime fragrance, which is actually going to last you quite a while, I get about 6 or 7 hours out of this, which is quite decent. Just look online, honestly, because a lot of fragrance shops around the world probably won't have this, and I do believe it's going discontinued soon, so do get your hands on it quite quickly. So this is my number 5, and it is D by Alfred Dunhill. My number 4, Chic for Men by Carolina Herrera. Now, this fragrance came out in 2004, and to me this one is just absolutely gorgeous. If you are a fan of sort of watermelon, then you're really gonna like this one. It is a little bit similar to the likes of 212 Man, also by this company, and fragrances like CH Men by Carolina Herrera. It's actually very, very similar to both of those fragrances. I find that a lot of fragrances from Carolina Herrera are actually very similar to one another. I don't know why that is, but to me this is a great one. You can only buy this one online, although I have had some people tell me that they have seen it available on Carolina Herrera counters in some stores, which is pretty cool. But here in the UK, you can only buy this online. I only paid 20 quid for this. It's an amazing juice. It is a little bit generic, but it has a nice watermelon note in it, which is actually really nice and juicy. It's very mouth-watering, so if you do like watermelon, like me, then this is a really good one to go for. It's just fresh, it's clean, it's very invigorating. So to me, perfect fragrance for the spring. So that is number four, Chic for Men by Carolina Herrera. My number three, guys, is this one right here, and this is Narciso Rodriguez for Him. I cannot get enough of this fragrance, hence why I'm showing it quite a lot in some of my top six videos. This is amazing. This is absolutely amazing. To me, this is like, say it's springtime and it's raining outside. To me, this is the perfect thunderstorm fragrance. If you're cooped up inside all cozy and warm and you don't want to go outside because it's obviously raining and it's cold, this is probably the most perfect fragrance you can possibly wear. It has a very earthy smell. It's got a lot of florals in there. It's got some violet leaf, I think it is. But it's very earthy, it's got a little bit of oak moss in there, it's got some sandalwood. Beautiful fragrance. In fact, this scent is inspired by a lot of older scents, but it's just absolutely gorgeous. The bottle to me is a work of art. It actually reminds me of a lot of other bottles out there, if I'm honest. It reminds me of, for example, the one by Dolce & Gabbana. Beautiful fragrance, looks like cement inside, which is also really cool. But if you're looking for a nice cozy fragrance, that's also very unique, this is a really good one to go for. The Eau de Parfum version is also really good. This is the EDT. I would highly recommend actually checking out the EDP if you're wanting something a little bit more invigorating, something a bit stronger. But this one is still strong, gets you about 8 hours. Great scent. Would highly recommend it. This is Narciso Rodriguez for Him, and that's my number three. Coming in at number two, guys, was actually my number one last year for the spring. And this one is it actually is one of the oldest on this list, and it is Sung Hom by Alfred Sung. Now this fragrance to me is just, it's amazing, guys. It's so nice. Soap in a bottle. In fact, guys, if you wear Irish Spring soap, this is that soap in a bottle. Absolutely amazing fragrance. In fact, this one is probably my most soapiest fragrance that I have in my whole collection. This was my number one on my top six soapy fragrances. And for a good reason, because it is literally soap in a bottle. It's just, it's no doubt mature, no doubt very old-fashioned, but it smells so clean. It smells so, like, it smells so vibrant. It's just so strong, you know? But who doesn't want to smell like a bar of soap? To me, this is perfect. And for the springtime, to me, springtime is about feeling clean. It's about feeling fresh, and it's about being smart. And I can imagine wearing this fragrance, with maybe wearing like a nice polo shirt and a nice pair of jeans in the springtime. To me, that's just perfect, you know? And this is my number two, guys, and it is Sung Hom by Alfred Sung. Great fragrance. Please do check it out. It is getting discontinued soon, I believe, even though I've heard that for the last 2 years, but you can never be too careful when it comes to the fragrance market. So you can get this one for fairly cheap online. I only paid 10 bucks for this in TJ Maxx. Amazing price. Great fragrance. Please do check it out. Number one, guys, and you're probably thinking, really? That fragrance? To be honest, I was quite surprised I picked this one, but I've been wearing it quite a lot for the past week or so, and it's been doing me wonders. It's been brilliant for me. And this is the very disrespected fragrance, I think, in the community. A lot of people don't give this a lot of respect. It is a historic scent. It's really stood the test of time, and it is the one and the only Grey Flannel by Geoffrey Beene. Now this fragrance came out in 1975, and let me tell you, everyone is slating this fragrance online. I'm not going to go into too much detail about that, but everybody, and I mean everyone, people are giving this fragrance bad reviews, and I don't know why. This fragrance is class. It's quality. Niche quality in a bottle. Yes, it is a bit strange, I'm not going to lie. It does smell mature, but my god, it's wonderful. Wonderful stuff. To me, this smells like a very powdery floral with a very mature, retro, earthy smell to it. Very peppery, very leathery, and very mossy. absolutely gorgeous. Got to wear it to spray it. Oh, it's just wonderful. I've heard people say that the vintage version is better, although this is the recent version. I think this one's made by Elizabeth Arden. Yeah, EA Fragrances. But it's fantastic. This fragrance will get me 12 plus hours of longevity, and the dry down on this scent is wonderful. It's so smooth, so soft, but so damn mossy. Like, if you like moss in fragrances and you like earthy scents, you need to give this one a try, guys. It's wonderful. And I don't know why, but it reminds me of the other day, because I went to a band practice, and it was a beautiful day, the sun was shining and everything, and I wore this fragrance to band practice, and a lot of people liked the way I smelled. They said, wow, you smell pretty good, what are you wearing? And I told them, and they'd never heard of it. But walking to band practice while I was outside, it made me feel really good. The fresh air was hitting me, and it was letting off this smell of the fragrance, and I felt really good, I felt really energized, and that is probably the main reason why I've decided to make this my number one on the list. It's an amazing scent, and I would highly recommend checking it out, guys. Don't listen to all the haters, okay? Because it's silly. It's honestly so silly, because this, just because it's an old fragrance, doesn't mean that it's bad, okay? Because it's not. And that's just my opinion. I'm not telling people to go out and try it. I'm just saying, don't listen to the haters, and just give it a try if you like, you know? Because at the end of the day, it's a good fragrance, and it should be respected more. That's all I think. I hope you've enjoyed this top 6 video. Please do let me know what you thought of the fragrances that I've chosen in this episode. Ugh, need to swallow there. And if you've liked the fragrances, do let me know in the comments below, guys. And as always, keep smelling good, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye-bye for now.